opened up with an awesome match. Not necessarily awesome bell-to-bell, although it was pretty awesome bell-to-bell, but mostly because these fans were out of their minds. It was Sting and Darby Allin beating 2.0, the former Ever-Rise. Just bell-to-bell madness and excitement, and fans going nuts, and Sting popping up out of a double powerbomb through a table, only to hit a double scorpion death drop at a double scorpion death lock to beat both of 2.0. If these dudes haven't been signed yet, I don't know what to tell you. They should be. Sammy Guevara beat Sean Spears after proposing earlier in the day to his girlfriend. So he got a win in his hometown, in an exciting match, in front of his girlfriend. A novel concept. It's actually not a novel concept. It's a novel concept in one place, but not here or anywhere else in wrestling. Everywhere else tries to get their baby faces over. We had Dan Lambert showing up with Andre Arlovsky and Junior Dos Santos issuing an open challenge. Lance Archer came out to accept the open challenge, but was it attacked by Scorpio Sky and Ethan Page. I don't think we're going to see matches with Junior Dos Santos and Andre Arlovsky. Oh, they were there on the show, and it set up two dudes beating up Lance Archer, so Lance is going to have to get a partner. In another great match, a fantastic match, I would go as far as to say, the Young Bucks beat the Jurassic Express. Another match where the crowd's just totally losing their minds and all sorts of great spots. They gave Jungle Boy everything. Tons of interference from the heels. And finally, they beat Jungle Boy. They beat Jungle Boy with the BTE trigger. And this led to an angle where there is a tournament to determine number one contenders for the Young Bucks tag team titles. The winners will get a shot at the Young Bucks in a cage coming up at the pay-per-view. And we could talk more about this later, but I think Jurassic Express is winning the tournament, and I think they're winning the tag team titles on that show. Some people don't like that idea, but too bad. I do. I'll tell you why later. We had Paul White doing a promo where he announced that he will be facing QT Marshall at All Out. So if you want a quick, violent match, that's the one for you on the pay-per-view. We had a bunch of other segments setting up matches. Taz, Hook, Death Triangle, etc., etc. Thunder Rosa beat Penelope Ford. So Thunder Rosa at some point. I don't know if it's going to be Thunder Rosa versus Britt Baker at the pay-per-view or Britt Baker and Chris Statlander. But clearly the big match you're building for at some point down the road is Thunder Rosa and Britt Baker. I guess we'll find out when that's going to be. They're also teasing a Jon Moxley-Tanahashi match. But again, 99.999999999999% sure that's not the match at All Out. But I don't know what the match is, so we shall see. We had a setup for next week. It's going to be young Brock Anderson attempting to... he's defending the good name of the Anderson family against Malachi Black in a match that will not go well, I don't think, for young Brock Anderson. Rampage is coming Friday. Jurassic Express versus Private Party. Title Eliminator. Jade Cargill, Kiera Hogan, Jon Moxley versus Daniel Garcia. Next week on Dynamite, Lucha Brothers versus the Varsity Blondes. Jamie Hayter versus Red Velvet. Orange Cassidy versus Matt Hardy. And Malachi Black versus Brock Anderson. And I would strongly suspect you're going to see CM Punk on both shows. And then the main event. It was MJF versus Chris Jericho. The fans did, in fact, sing Chris Jericho to the ring for the match. The fans did not appear to believe at all that MJF had any chance of beating Chris Jericho. The story was that Jericho's elbow is still destroyed from MJF throwing him off the cage through the stage. And of course, Chris Jericho cannot use the Judas effect. So at the very end of the match, he was about to use it, but he realized he couldn't. He was momentarily distracted by his own inability to use his finisher. MJF hit him with the Judas effect. MJF put him in the salt of the earth on the bad arm. Jericho tried one cradle. It didn't work. MJF put him back in the salt of the earth. And Chris Jericho tapped out. I was shocked, but that was a finish. And I guess we'll see where they go from here, because they are clearly going to go somewhere from here. I don't know where, but it's a follow-up that's important. And I guess we'll follow up on either Friday or next week's Dynamite and find out where they're going for the pay-per-view. I would not be surprised if perhaps we had Sammy Guevara versus MJF and Sammy got his big win over MJF on that show, but I don't know that. I don't know where they're going. But we have a couple of weeks left to build up whatever it is. So we shall see. Mike, your thoughts on this show?
They had a lot going on, but I thought they accomplished a whole lot, too, and I don't even know where you want to begin. There's so much to talk about. I mean, there's even things that were not said and not built to that we could even talk about. I mean, Lance Archer's got a history with Minoru Suzuki. Minoru Suzuki and Jon Moxley would be a match on American soil. Probably would be pretty good. If you're going to maybe have Dan Lambert do something with some guys who may not have a ton of experience in the wrestling ring, Minoru Suzuki, maybe Lance Archer might be a good person to get in the ring with. So we don't even know what direction they could possibly be going there, other than Lance Archer looks like he's going to have a partner to face these cronies of Dan Lambert, which apparently Scorpio Sky and Ethan Page are. So who knows what's going to take place there. Again, Sammy Guevara. I mean, hey, they could do what they did with Angel Garza down in NXT, which is, you know, of course, have him propose to his wife and then instantly make him a Lothario as well, too, who's actually a heel, which that was another thing that they did.
Who actually can't get any women.
Yes, then lost all interest in that one, which was a complete disaster. But it looks like they actually put a exclamation point on the end of that feud. I know Sammy said that, hey, this is over, and I don't think he just meant the match. I think he actually was tipping his hat to the feud. Sting coming out there with 2.0, like you mentioned. I don't know what their status is right now, and it was kind of an awkward teaming with Daniel Garcia, but I tell you what, they're fantastic, and I hope they do more with that tag team division, which apparently it looks like they're moving something forward there. I agree with you. Jurassic Express getting the win. I was surprised with Jungle Boy taking the L last night, but if they're going to go on and get the victory, I think it's a great idea, because if you wanted to have a rematch with the Young Bucks, you can. If you want to put them in a feud with FTR, you can. You can put them in a feud with anybody. They're going to be the default baby faces, so I think that would be a great idea right there. The main event was a surprise. I thought Jericho was going to get the victory, but obviously Jericho and MJF are not done yet. So I thought the way the whole thing played out, I thought it was really good. They had a lot to set up. You know, maybe it was superfluous to have that interview with Andrade and Pac, but it was quick. They moved things on. They got it done. Same thing with, you know, QT Marshall and Big Show. I thought it was kind of weird and kind of wacky they're putting this match together. But again, you know, Big Show working with somebody inexperienced or being around so he could be there for somebody inexperienced, like Anthony Ogogo, who we haven't seen for a while. Does he come back to give his knockout punch to Big Show? Or, I'm sorry, Paul White, who's probably going to be delivering a knockout punch to QT Marshall? Who knows? So there was a lot we can get into when it comes to this show. There was something in every segment that's moving something forward, and not the least of which was CM Punk as well, which, as we barrel towards Friday, there was no mention of whatsoever.
You know, the more I think about it, the more I am considering that they could be doing Sammy Guevara versus MJF at All Out, because Sammy did get a huge win, and they put him over big. And Chris Jericho put over MJF. And, I mean, honestly, if you're trying to build a promotion and you're building up MJF, who benefits more from beating MJF for the future, Chris Jericho or Sammy Guevara? Obviously, the answer is Sammy Guevara. And where Jericho goes, I don't know, because the key to a guy like Jericho is his job, ultimately, is to build the next generation of wrestlers. But you can't build the next generation of wrestlers unless you win the vast majority of the time. So he's going to need a win at some point down the road. But the big win over MJF? MJF got the big win over Jericho. Sammy gets a big win over MJF.
Eric Tyler Mullins wants to know, if you had no restrictions at all in your diet, what food would you love to eat over and over again?
Cup of noodles is my favorite.
Your choice is cup of noodles?
Uh-huh.
Not a steak or escargot?
Nope.
Cup o' noodles.
Yeah, that's the only thing that doesn't upset my stomach.
Well, I think the question, Granny, is if it didn't upset your stomach, if there were no consequences, you could just eat any food.
I still say cup of noodles.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.